to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Well, we're here tonight to educate NRA members on what they can do to educate other people in their communities to make sure that they vote for candidates that will support Second Amendment rights.
It's incredibly important for us as gun owners and NRA members to get together tonight to talk about what we can do to elect pro-gun candidates this November. We know that the NRA that is successful on election day is you. It's not me. It's not Jordon, our lobbyist here in Kansas. It's you. You have the power to convince the 76 million non-NRA gun owners across the country. Yeah, today we have close to 80 to 90 million gun owners all across America, yet there are only 4 million NRA members. We know that you're educated. We know that you know the attacks we're under. It's the other 76 million we're worried about. And so that's what we're going to do tonight. I'm going to give you the tools and the information so you can go into your own gun communities to talk with them about how they can get involved, what they can do. And the first step in doing that is electing pro-gun candidates on November the 2nd. Kevin Yoder here in the 3rd Congressional District.
This is fantastic. These are all not only NRA members, but KSRA members and shooters here at the Bullet Hole, and almost all of them have taken a class from me.
We give them 2 more years of control of this government, or even worse, 6 more years. So we got to get something done in November. We have to win this seat back for the people of the 3rd District. Now, I know Nancy Pelosi and the folks in Washington want to keep this seat. In fact, they believe this seat is theirs. And they're going to spend a lot of money to bring this seat back home for the Democratic Party so that Nancy Pelosi can remain Speaker of the House. I will tell all of you, this is not Nancy Pelosi's seat. This is our seat. The 3rd District owns the seat. Now, there's a lot of critical issues facing this country. We're going to talk about the Second Amendment tonight because that's the focal point and that's what's very important. But there are a lot of critical issues facing this country that are killing jobs, that are running up the deficit. We've got a $13.5 trillion deficit now, debt in this country. That's $120,000 for every person in this room, and it's getting greater by the second. In the month of August, the folks in Washington spent over $150 billion more dollars than they had coming in. That can't work. You can't run a country like that. You couldn't run a business like that. If any of you ran your own personal lives like that, you'd be in bankruptcy, you'd lose your house overnight. And those folks in Washington think they can spend our money, they think they can spend our children's money and our grandchildren's money because we're not going to hold them accountable. We're going to hold them accountable this fall. November 2nd is a referendum on those policies coming out of Washington. And when I see this $13 trillion debt and I know the legacy that they want to leave to our children and grandchildren, it's immoral and it has to be stopped. And I want to lead the charge to stop it. Now, it's causing a lot of problems, these policies in Washington. Not only is it running up the deficit, but they're causing unemployment across this country, across this community. 9.6% unemployment in this country. That's staggering. The unemployment rate has been higher for this long of period. It's never been this bad since the Great Depression in terms of unemployment almost at 10% for this point. And you hear what the folks in Washington say. They say, that's business's fault. Business is the problem. The small business owners, big business, they're the ones who are killing this economy. Trust government. If you put us in power, we'll create prosperity. We'll make it so. But we know back here in the heartland of Kansas, that's not how the world works. We know that free markets, free enterprise, individual liberty, individual responsibility, those are American ideals. And when we look at this nation, we compare it to other nations around the world, there are some unique things about the United States.
The Castle Doctrine,
teamed up with the NRA on that. We work to make the concealed carry laws uniform so that when you drive from Mission to Merriam to Overland Park to Leawood to Overland Park to Olathe, you're not being hit with 5 or 6 different laws all along the way. I mean, how can anybody even keep up with that? Now, I'll tell you, don't boo, but I am a lawyer, and lawyers are people too. Lawyers are people too, okay? But it would take a team of lawyers to figure out all the individual gun laws if you let every city and every county in the state come up with their own set of different rules. And so I fought along with others to make sure that those rules are uniform. This November, we're going to have a ballot issue, we're all aware of, on the Constitution, to make sure that our Second Amendment rights are protected in the Kansas Constitution, and that it's very clear that those Second Amendment rights are individual rights. That it's not a right to create an army, it's an individual right to bear arms. And what that does is it protects us, that no matter what the United States Supreme Court says about the U.S. Constitution, how that's interpreted, and we all know that it's very plain in what it means. We have an individual right to bear arms. But there's always attempts to interpret and change those rules in Washington. We know that regardless of what they do, we're going to protect our rights right here in Kansas, and this is always going to be a safe haven for gun owners and hunters and people who respect liberty and the Constitution right here in Kansas. And we're going to lead the charge this fall to get it done on November 2nd.
If you change your mind, take a chance. I'm the first in line. Take a chance. Honey, I'm still free. Take a chance on me. Take a chance. If you need me, let me know. Gonna be around. If you got no place to go when you're feeling down. If you're all alone, when the pretty birds have flown, honey, I'm still free. Take a chance on me.